Recorded Books presents Nina Soni, Master of the Garden by Kashmira Sheth. Illustrated by Jen Kosmirsky. Narrated by Soneela Nankani. Chapter 1. My luck had finally arrived. I opened my bedroom window a crack and sniffed. Yes, it was here. I could tell just by the scent of the air. It had a warm, rich, earthy smell to it. The sun was shining. The forget-me-not blue flower sky was clear, and there was not a speck of snow anywhere. Almost every year in Wisconsin, take our daughters and sons to work day is cold, snowy, rainy, windy, or a combination. That meant I usually ended up inside doing computer work with Dad, or helping Mom order seeds, or plan a garden for someone. Dad loves his software engineering work, but it is difficult to understand, and I can't do much to help. Ordering seeds is about as exciting as watching my sister Kavita sing. Not very enjoyable. And it is no fun to plant a garden but not plant it. This year, the weather was beautiful, and I couldn't wait to start digging. Mom is a landscape architect, so today, Kavita and I could garden with her. Kavita is in first grade, so she was more into playing than planting. I am in fourth grade, so this was going to be my responsibility. Responsibility means something rests on your shoulders, and you must take care of it. I came downstairs to the kitchen. Luckily, Mom was already there. Mom, isn't it a nice day to garden? I asked. Sure is, Kavita said. She must have followed me quietly. Mom looked out the window. Yes, plenty of sunshine and no wind. I had a bowl of oatmeal, and Kavita had Cheerios. We topped our breakfasts with banana slices and blueberries. They were both easy to prepare, eat, and clean up afterward. On a busy and important day, it is smart to make a super-fast breakfast choice. It saves time and energy. As she took her empty bowl to the sink, Kavita sang the same song over and over again. Garden, garden, dig and plant. Garden, garden, water and weed. Garden, garden, harvest and feast. Okay. I was also excited about the garden, but I was not ready to listen to Kavita singing about it 1,000 times over. I loaded the bowls into the dishwasher. Why don't you save your energy for digging? Only people with little energy worry about saving it. She spread her arms wide. I have a lot of energy, so I can use it as much as I want. Still, shouldn't you be careful? It's like saving money. You don't want to spend it just because you have it. Kavita was quiet. That meant she was thinking. She has always loved to sing. I have always tried to discourage her, especially in public. But it hasn't worked. Kavita has her own mind. Though it took me a long time to understand that, I still forget sometimes. I kind of like that Kavita is her own person. Most of the time, I mean. I also have my own mind, but it's not a singing mind. It's a list-making mind. Here is the in-my-head list of why a list-making mind is so useful. It keeps me organized. It keeps me focused. It keeps me kind of interesting. It's not that I am boring, but sometimes I think Kavita's singing is slightly more attention-grabbing. Attention-grabbing or not, it was time to get going on Take Our Daughters and Sons to Work Day. Are you ready, Mom? I asked. I want to have my chai first. In my excitement, I had forgotten that Mom and Dad need their tea before they start their mornings. Until they drink their chai, they are as slow as slugs. Only after they chug their chai, which is really tea with ginger, spices, and milk, do they become non-sluggish. Then they start darting like rabbits from here to there. Kavita took out paper and crayons from her art box. She spread them on the dining table. As she colored, she sang again. Garden, garden, dig and plant. I shook my head. She saw me and stopped. Nina, I sing because I don't want to burst. You can't burst. I walked closer to her. Have you ever seen anyone burst? A balloon. You're not filled with air. She smoothed out the paper with her hands. When I sleep, I gather a lot of energy, and when I am awake, I use it, right? Sounds right to me. I looked at Kavita's drawing, a diagram of a garden. It was filled with plants of different heights and colors. Impressive. Impressive means something that makes you go, wow. She had drawn vines with pea pods hanging on them, plants full of red and green peppers, and a row of something else, but I couldn't tell what it was. Maybe it was some kind of a root crop. Kavita shook my arm. Why aren't you answering me? I looked at her. What's your question? She rested her hands on the table. Okay, I will repeat it one more time, but that's it. Try me. If I don't use up any energy, then I will have too much of it. And if all that energy doesn't burst me, wouldn't it hurt? Why would it hurt? If you eat too much, you overstuff your stomach. It doesn't burst your tummy, but it hurts. If you overstuff your body with energy, it will hurt. Today, we're going to garden, and you'll spend energy. I made a circle with my arm to show how much. A lot of it. She picked up another crayon and began coloring furiously. I guess she wasn't spending any energy listening to me. How long have you been working on your drawing? I asked.
For a week.
She picked up the paper and showed it to me.
Do you like it?
It looked even better when she held it up.
I do. Mom says it is good to make plans before you plant.
I nodded.
So this is my plan. I know exactly what I am going to plant, where I am going to plant, and how the plants will look.
I, a fourth grader, a list maker, was the one who had asked Mom if we could have our own vegetable plots. But my sister, a first grader, a singer, had already drawn her garden plan. Why hadn't I? Now I was kind of not happy with myself. I glanced at Mom and Dad. They were just getting ready to drink their chai. I had time. I went back to my room and opened Sakhi. Sakhi means friend in Hindi. I have named my notebook. It is good to name a notebook that is special to you, because then you feel like you can tell your notebook all your secrets. I write just about everything in Sakhi, mostly lists. Sakhi is a good friend and is always ready for me to tell her new things. My garden list. Draw a diagram of a garden. Fill the patch with good soil and compost. Make a list of vegetables to plant. Get seeds. Mom probably already has seeds. And plant them. Water, only if it doesn't rain, and weed. Harvest and eat. The last two on the list sounded a lot like Kavita's song. That was okay, I told myself. Sometimes Kavita's songs do make sense. This was one of them. Then I had another idea. What if we have too many vegetables? What could we do with them? I opened a new page in Sakhi and started writing. Business plan to sell extra vegetables. Advertise by making up flyers for neighbors. Mention location, time, and vegetables that are available. Arrange vegetables in baskets. Make signs with prices. Give free samples. Hand out recipes. This was perfect! I rushed back downstairs. Mom, can I use your pencils to draw my garden plan? Mom has several fancy mechanical pencils and colored pencils. She uses them when she draws shrubs, walkways,
trees and flowers on her plans, which show her clients what their gardens will look like. Please use the ones that are on the table. Don't open any new packs or boxes. As soon as I finish my chai and change, we'll start our project. Thanks, I said. I held one of Mom's pencils and doodled, but not with the pencil, and not on a piece of paper. It was as if each thought I had was a pencil, and my mind was a blank piece of paper. I doodled in my head, imaginary plants with imaginary vegetables growing on them. Without thinking, I switched to list making. Here is my in-my-head list. April is almost over. That means I can start planting soon. It will be fun to take care of the plants and watch them grow, grow, grow. Butterflies will visit, and hummingbirds will flap their wings like crazy. The bees will find nectar, and the earthworms will find a home. By the end of summer, I will have a beautiful garden with tons of vegetables. We will be able to eat and sell fresh, crunchy vegetables. With luck, I will be master of the garden. Nina Soni, master of the garden. It had a healthy, nutritious sound to it. I kept munching on the idea over and over again. Chapter 2. The doorbell rang. Since Dad was nowhere in sight and Mom was getting ready, I looked through the glass panel to see who it was. Jay, my best friend, gave me a thumbs-up sign through the window. What was he doing here? I put the pencil down, stopped the in-my-head plan-making, and opened the door. Hi, Nina, Jay said.
Jay! Yay!
Kavita yelled from the dining room. She sure knows his voice. Before I could ask Jay why he had come, he said, Looks like you're ready to garden.
How do you know?
Because your mom invited me to garden. Also, you're wearing old pants that are too short on you. I rolled my eyes as I went to the kitchen. How come Jay always notices things about me when I don't want him to? How come Mom didn't tell me she'd invited Jay? He followed. Did you have breakfast?
Yes.
Are you hungry? Only if you have something yummy. Jay loves the fresh Indian breads Mom makes, but we didn't have any leftovers from last night.
Sorry, no paratha or roti.
I had oatmeal, I said. No thanks, not hungry. Mom walked in.
Jay, right on time. Ready?
He took off his jacket and hung it on one of the counter stools. I stared. Jay was wearing a t-shirt with a picture of a pile of dirt and a shovel and the words, Let's dig, in large letters. Sure, Jay is my best friend, but he wears some really strange t-shirts. He has one that says, Ask me how to dance. Now, this one had a picture of a shovel. At least it didn't say, Ask me how to garden.
Aren't you going with your mom or dad to their work? I asked.
Nope. I'm here to garden.
Yay!
Kavita said. I was happy too. I mean, gardening with Kavita was fun. But gardening with Kavita and Jay was going to be double the fun. The trouble with my brain is that when something new comes in, the old plan kind of gets derailed. Derailed means that something doesn't stay on its track. Drawing my garden went off when I started brain doodling. Then Jay came in. Now, even brain doodling was off my thinking track. And really, it was for the best, because Mom was ready. I pointed at the door. Let's go out.
Not yet, Mom said.
She sat at the dining table. We gathered around her.
So what is the first thing we should consider when we have a garden? She asked.
Oh, no. She was turning this into a lesson. Jay and I glanced at each other. Kavita raised her hand. I guess she also thought this was a class.
Yes, Kavita, Mom said.
Follow my plan.
We'll do that, Mom smiled.
What are the things plants need to grow?
Songs, seeds, and shovels, Kavita shouted.
You supply songs,
Mom said to Kavita. Then she gestured toward Jay and me.
Nina and Jay will supply shovels, and I will supply seeds.
Jay and I needed to step up. I raised my hand. Jay elbowed me. I ignored him.
Nina,
Mom said. Sun, soil, and water. There, I listed the rest of the things plants need.
I have chosen the spot that gets the most sun,
Mom said.
But I thought we were going to grow our vegetables in the same plot you do, I said.
Mom's eyes twinkled.
We're going to make new garden beds by the left side of the garage. Raised garden beds.
What about the lawn growing there? Jay asked.
We must put down something so that the grass doesn't grow. What would be good material to use for that?
Feet, Kavita said. We can run on the grass and trample it.
I don't think feet is the material Mom is thinking of, I said.
Kavita looked at Mom. Feet is the best material, right? Mrs. Crump said, don't trample my grass. You'll kill it.
Kavita, Mrs. Crump said that after she had planted a new lawn. She didn't want you to walk on it. This grass has been there for a long time. It'll be harder to get rid of. We have to use something else to remove it, Mom said.
I have a pile of newspaper in the garage. Can you three bring it out while I get the kiddie swimming pool? Mom was making notes.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.